Hello, this is Christian Espinoza with Alpine Security. The purpose of this video is to show you why you should not click on links in emails you receive. It's much better to go visit the website rather than click on a link to a website. The example we're going to show today is a Cyber Monday sale. I just received this email from Best Buy earlier today. And I modified the email a little bit, similar to what a hacker would do, to show you what the repercussions can be if you click on a link in the email. This is the email on the left side. This is the victim's computer. On the right side is the attacker's computer. So I'm going to show you what it looks like from the attacker's perspective and from the victim's perspective all at once. This is the email I received this morning from Best Buy. The only thing I changed was instead of bestbuy.com, now it says best-buy.com. This is an example of what an attacker may do. And most of us won't notice that it's best-buy instead of Best Buy. And a lot of us don't even realize that Best Buy and best-buy may not be the same thing. This is just an example though. So I modified this here. So the idea is if you click on one of these links, like I'm hovering over this link right here, it points to best-buy.com rather than bestbuy.com. So the idea is if I'm the attacker, I'm going to send you a phishing email, modify the links in the email to go to a website that's not really Best Buy, but looks like Best Buy. And when you click on the link, the attacker can infect your computer or take over your browser or download malicious software or steal your information. There's various things the attacker can do. But the moral of the story is don't click on links and emails. Attackers take great advantage of holidays and promotions such as Black Friday, Cyber Monday, Christmas specials, New Year's, anything to entice you to click on the link in the email. Also, there's typically a sense of urgency, like this email here. We have 23 hours left to take advantage of the sale. So some people, rather than browse, open up a browser and type in bestbuy.com, they may click on the link in the email. And sometimes you think, well, if I go to the website, will the special still apply to me? Or do I actually have to click on the link? There's a risk with clicking on the link, though. If I go to the actual Best Buy website here, bestbuy.com, the real one, there's no dash. We see I can still take advantage of Cyber Monday. So I don't have to click on the link in the email. So if I do click on the link in the email though, this is what we're going to demonstrate. If I click on this link, it takes me to a page. Let's see, it's opening up. It looks just like the page we were at. It looks like Best Buy. On the attacker's computer over here, this is what they can see. So it looks like you're on the Best Buy site, but you're actually on the attacker's website, and the attacker directed some JavaScript code or basically some code to run in your browser. There's a lot the attacker can do. I'm not going to go through all these options here, but these are all the options the attacker has. Not all of them are going to work, but the whole point of the story here is don't click on a link in an email. Otherwise, this is the kind of stuff an attacker can do. As an example, I can click on social engineering over here. And if I know and I figured out, because if I go back up here, if I figured out that you have LastPass as your password manager, because I can detect LastPass, let's say, if I figured that out, then what I can do is trick you into entering your LastPass credentials. So if I scroll down here to social engineering, I can do a fake last pass. So when I execute this on the victim's computer, it should prompt them to log on to last pass, which we just see right there popped up. So if you are using last pass and you log on here, now I've stolen your last pass credentials. So I could say test at test.com, which if I get your last pass credentials, that's like the keys to the kingdom to all of your passwords, right? So I log in here and nothing happens. It doesn't actually log in. But on the attacker's computer, we should have stolen and captured those credentials. So these are just a few things that an attacker can do when you click on a link in an email and visit a site that's not really the site you're trying to purchase something from. There's a lot of other things they can do. This is just a very simple demonstration. I'll do one more thing here, and then we'll go ahead and wrap up the video. So something else an attacker can do, and a lot of people are very concerned about webcams, is an attacker can turn on your webcam through a browser if you visit a website. Most modern browsers today will ask you for permission. Like you notice here on the browser, it says, let Best Buy use your webcam. If you're using an older browser or you don't have your permission set up properly, the webcam might go ahead and turn on. So now the webcam is enabled on this computer over here, and you see the little dot there. So it's recording, and the attacker can record whatever they want to now that the webcam is enabled. So what that does, and I'll let that run for a second. So I'm gonna go back over here to the attacker machine, make it a little bit larger. So this is what the attacker's machine has now. It's got a picture of me right there, not a flattering picture. One of the problems I think with cybersecurity is there's a lot of talk about what can and can't be done, but it's rarely demonstrated. So I wanted to take this opportunity through this video to demonstrate what it looks like from an attacker perspective and what it looks like from the victim perspective. So next time you receive a phishing email or an email that looks like it's legitimate, you think twice before you click on the link in the email. And instead, you actually go to the website and enter the URL directly into your browser. I hope you found this video useful. Hopefully it helps you become more secure on the internet. Please like the video, subscribe to our channel, click on the little bell to get notified when we have new videos come out. And thanks for watching.